So Drayton Manor is a park with so much promise at the moment. With installations such as Vikings and Adventure Cove, they've really established themselves as a key player in the UK theme park market. Today, I'm going to be talking about what I would like to see at the resort as part of their 5-year development plan. So if you're going to find this video interesting or you're going to find it useful, please smack that like button, hit that subscribe button and turn on all notifications so you don't miss a single video. Without further ado, let's get straight on into it. So the first thing I would love to see installed at Drayton Manor is a Vekoma launch coaster. Since the closure of G-Force, the park only has one standout roller coaster, and that's Shockwave. I would love to see a Vekoma launch coaster installed at the park, as I feel like it would properly flesh out the park's lineup in terms of roller coasters, because apart from Shockwave, all you have is Troublesome Trucks, Accelerator and Jormungandr. So I feel like a Vekoma launch coaster would be a pretty versatile model for Drayton Manor to go for, because they could make this as inversion heavy or as family friendly as they wanted it to be. Now Drayton Manor are going more down the family thrill route, so what they could do is add a couple of inversions, but make the layout fairly windy. Nothing too exciting, but still thrilling nonetheless. Now sticking on the topic of Vekoma, I would love to see Drayton Manor install an STC, a suspended thrill coaster. Now one of these recently opened up at Trips Thrill, and it looks to be really good and targeted towards that family thrill market. Now yes, this has inversions, but from those that have ridden it, they've said that it's not too intense, so I feel like this would be perfect for Drayton Manor, particularly because they don't have a suspended roller coaster already. Now moving away from Vekoma then, let's talk about Gerschlauer. Now like Vekoma, Gerschlauer are a manufacturer that Drayton Manor already have a relationship with, because the Troublesome Trucks ride in the Thomasland area of the park, that is a Gerschlauer roller coaster. Now, Gerschlauer are making a few different models of family coaster at the moment, and each one of them look to be really good, so I feel like Drayton Manor could do something really special with Gerschlauer if they were to choose them. Now, if Drayton Manor wanted to, they could always purchase a Gerschlauer Eurofighter. Now, I say a Gerschlauer Eurofighter because Gerschlauer Eurofighters don't have to be particularly inversion heavy. You could make them more airtime based, or like I said with the Vekoma launch coaster, you could make it more twisty and turny, and that would definitely fit in with their family thrill direction. Now let's move away from steel coasters then and talk about wooden roller coasters, because I love my wooden roller coasters, and I feel like a wooden roller coaster would suit Drayton Manor really, really well. Now I'm looking at something on the scale of Heidi the Ride or Wicker Man in terms of a wooden roller coaster that would suit Drayton Manor. Now, I say these roller coasters specifically because they're not too tall, and I don't feel like Drayton Manor could build a wooden roller coaster that would take over the skyline. Now, Drayton Manor could definitely go down the custom route, or they could get a Heidi the Ride clone. I feel like that would be a smart decision, but making their own custom layout, something quite low to the ground with a lot of airtime, would definitely suit the park really well, as I feel like airtime is something the park lacks a lot. So I've talked a lot about what I want to see, but let's talk about where this could go. Now there is one prime space of land at the moment that I would love to see a roller coaster go in, and that is where Apocalypse is at the moment, where Pandemonium's old site is, and where the Flying Dutchman is. This is a big piece of land, and one that a decent sized roller coaster could go in. If they wanted to remove another ride, they could even remove the Drunken Barrels building and make the roller coaster weave around there. They've got a lot of options in terms of that space. Now, another piece of land I would love to see the park expand into is the overflow car park behind Thomasland. Now, this comes with its own set of issues, as you're effectively cutting off one of the exit roads to Drayton Manor, and they use this on busier days when they need to get a lot of cars out at once. But I could see some ways around this, and I could definitely see the park expanding into that area of land in the future. Now, one last thing I want to talk about before I end this video is the Pirates Adventure Building. Now, this is another space of land I could see Drayton Manor using for a roller coaster in the future. And what I would love to see in that space is an indoor roller coaster. So you could install a small Vekoma family coaster, theme it up really well, which Drayton Manor have proved that they can do and make this something special if they wanted to. I definitely feel like an indoor roller coaster would be possible within that Pirates Adventure building. And again, it's something I would love to see in the future. So guys, that's been me talking about what I would love to see come to Drayton Manor as part of their 5-year development plan. If you've got your own thoughts and opinions, or you'd like to see something else come to Drayton Manor, please let me know down in the comment section below. I'd be really interested to hear your thoughts. And don't forget to subscribe if you're not already, as I've got plenty of content coming down the pipeline for you guys. I've been Ryan from MyCoaster, and I shall see you in the next video. Goodbye.